just about time for football once again. EA Sports is proud to bring you this exciting NFL broadcast. And now to Tom Hammond and Chris Collinsworth for the game. Tom?
It should be cloudy but mild for today's game. Good afternoon, folks. Tom Hammond and Chris Collinsworth coming to you live. Chris, I have to say I'm excited about this one.
You know, everything starts up front. Talking about the offensive linemen, about the defensive linemen, they have to play well in this one. Both coaches have to challenge these big guys offensively and defensively.
And we're underway. Fielded at the 9. Brought down at the 29-yard line. Their offense will step onto the field for the first time, hoping to come away with some points on this possession. The offense will start at the 29-yard line. Minnesota is going with the offset eye backfield. Uses the stiff arm, but the defender is still able to drop him. So that play goes for about 6. That'll bring up second down. Second and 4 coming up here. Ball on the 35-yard line. The Vikings line up in an I formation. Draw play. He's dropped at the 36-yard line. 2-yard gain, and that makes it 3rd down. Third down now. They'll need about 3 yards to convert for a new set of downs. Here's the give. Brought down around the 49-yard line. An amazing run.
Well, if you want to know why all those coaches take stopwatches to the NFL Combine, you just saw it. You get a guy with that sort of athleticism, that sort of speed out there in the open field. Boy, is it fun to watch.
First down now and 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. They'll come out in the shotgun. And they use motion. He drops back to pass. Throws it short. And it's completed. And they get him at the 33-yard line. And it's the tailback with a big catch.
And tailbacks love that. Anytime they can get into the open field, think about that position. You're constantly pounding the ball inside and getting hit by those big linebackers. Now you get out in open space and you have a chance to make a play.
From the 33-yard line, the backfield is in the offset I formation. They'll throw on first down. Dumps it out right. He tried to stiff arm, but was tackled. The tight end came up with a nice catch that time.
Pretty athletic play for a big guy. I tell you, as a quarterback, you see somebody. like that, you want to come back again and again.
Looking for the score here on first down. The Vikings line up in a goal line formation. He's under pressure. There for the catch. He's dropped at the six. And the defense just ate that one up, Chris.
Yeah, you're not going to fool this defense on plays like that very much. At least he got the ball out of there, though.
We're scoreless after one as we get set for the second quarter. Six yards away from pay dirt here. They'll go from the shotgun. Back to throw. Looking for a receiver. Looks like he had it, but it's knocked loose. The intended receiver just got laid out.
Boy, that was a big hit. I'm not surprised at all he couldn't hold on to that one.
Third and goal situation here. The ball 6 yards out. The Vikings come out in a single back formation. Looks to pass. Huge pressure by the defense. And he's out of bounds, incomplete. The quarterback put that one too far out in front of his receiver, and he couldn't stay inbound.
He tried to make a safe throw there, but the receiver was open. It didn't have to be quite that cautious and just let him out of bounds.
Fourth down. They'll line this one up. This one 23 yards away. Right down the middle. He put that one right through the upright. And we'll take a quick look at the drive summary. Kicks it off. Jackson from the two. And he's drilled. What a hit.
You need to keep these guys honest. Power it up between the tackles a time or two.
The offense will take over at the 17. First and 10. Philadelphia comes out with an I formation. He doesn't get back to the line. A great defensive effort there.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Second down now with 10 to go. Ball on the 17. The Eagles set up in the gun. Philadelphia using an audible. Play fake. Steps up in the pocket. McNabb seems to be a little shaken up on that play.
Well, you have to go with a long pass here. So go with the hard count. And if they don't bite, make sure you get the first down.
Now looking at a third and long situation after the sack. There are three wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He's looking to throw. Looks for a man open. Almost intercepted. He threw that one right into coverage.
Well, you can't just stare down one receiver on a play like that. The defense is going to be all over it. He was lucky he didn't get picked off there.
Here's the kick. He got some distance on it. It's on the ground. What happened there, Chris?
How many times have we seen this happen in the past? A guy takes his eyes off the ball, trying to see what's happening in front of him. The guy's coming down to make the tackle. Take your eyes off of it just for a second, and you lose it.
Westbrook alone in the backfield. Westbrook on the handoff. And he's crushed at the 45-yard line. He tries to wriggle away, but he's stopped for a loss.
Well, Tom, the offensive line just didn't get any push there. They've got to do a better job knocking those guys off the line of scrimmage.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 45-yard line. Philadelphia lines up with three receivers, single back formation. Rifles it out there. He's tackled at the 30. Everything seemed to work perfectly on that one.
And that's a pattern that this team likes to run. You know they've been studying that all week on film, and yet they still can't stop it.
Lining up with three wide. He drops back with the hard throw out to his right. That play is worthy of another look. Here's Chris Collinsworth with the EA Sports Backtrack breakdown of the play.
Looking at this one more time, you'll see that they went with a blitz package on defense, and that allowed the tight end to get open in his pattern downfield.
Remind your guys up front that they're the key to this one. Pass protection is critical because they need to give the quarterback enough time to set up, find the open receiver, and release the ball.
Goes through his read. Nearly picked off. He should have had that one. A great play by the defense to knock the ball away.
And these defenders have been close all day. You better be careful if you're the quarterback. One of those is going to turn into an interception.
Shotgun formation. On play action. Gets rid of the ball. He's brought down right around the 12-yard line. And a pretty smart play call right there.
It really is so much the key to football. You talk all the time about you have to establish the run. Well, there you see why. You establish the run, and then you come with the play-action pass. Just so hard to defend.
He'll try the end zone. Almost picked.
You're in a good position here. Get the snap, drop back, and let your guys get open. Don't force anything.
Fakes to the back. Passes to the end zone. Threw it right to him, but he can't hang on. And here's a perfect opportunity. Cole takes it back. Makes the short throw. He's dropped at the 4. Nice pass, but not enough for the first. That'll bring up 4th down.
Pretty nice play that time. They picked up some good yardage. But they lost the battle on first and second down and left themselves in third and long. Just too much to overcome.
And it splits the uprights. Pretty good kick that time, and he drives it home for 3 points. Nice job. The kick is away. Hicks takes it at the 12. Drill at the 25. Once again, we'll take this opportunity to remind you that this game is brought to you by the fine folks at EA Sports. They'll start this drive at the 25.
First down, 10 to go. He looks to throw on first down. Brings this one in. He makes the tackle, and he had nothing but green grass in front of him. They get a nice gain there.
And what do you do when you're trying to cover a guy with that kind of speed? You have to back off of him. You have to respect his speed, and then he can do just about anything to you.
He's going to be tackled for a loss. Well, they wind up in reverse that time. Good push by the defense.
And when the defense gets that kind of penetration, it just disrupts everything for an offense. They have to get that guy blocked.
Jackson drops back, looks down the field, is there for the catch. Brought down at about the 33-yard line. Great time for that type of pass. It worked to perfection.
And that was a nice job by the offensive line, allowing the quarterback enough time to survey the field and find the open guy.
First and 10, ball on the 34-yard line. Kick is up, and he got all of this one right down the middle. That attempt didn't look like it had a chance.
Yeah, he worked that one over the bar, didn't he? You could see the body language and the tilt. He was trying to squeeze, and it just made a good kick.
Kicks it off from his own goal line. Hit and dropped at the 30. And we come to halftime here. The score is 6-3.
Thanks, guys. It's been a hard-fought game, and both of these teams have had their share of big plays. Here are a few.
He kicks it off. Jackson from the three. Big hit there to bring him down. So as the offense heads back onto the field, we'll take this time to remind you that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. If it's in the game, it's in the game. Play fake. Here's the throw. Makes the grab. Tackled at the 48-yard line. That one worked just as they drew it up.
Good pass, good catch. I agree. Sometimes there's really nothing you can do as a defense to stop a well-executed pass play.
From the 48-yard line. Offset I formation in the backfield. Setting up play action. Rockets it out. And he caught it. Defense pushes him out of bounds at the 36-yard line. A good play to the tight end that time.
And tight ends are so big that as coverage people, it's tough to figure out how to defend them. If you're on their left side, they throw it to their right side. If you're behind them, they throw it in front. Tight ends are tough to cover.
He's brought down at the 35. A two-yard run by the halfback.
One of the keys to running the ball is reading your blocks. Let those big old guys in the offensive line pave the way for you and just cut off them.
Feeds it to the back. Dukes away, and he will be tackled. A 7-yard play, and so it'll be third down. Third and a yard now. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll go from the shotgun. McNabb back to throw. Looking for an open man. And they get him around the 18-yard line. That one worked pretty well.
It sure did, and I wish all our fans could see what's happening down the field on all our television broadcasts, because so much of the game now is won and lost in the secondary.
Little handoff. Hit and drop behind the line. The quarterback did a nice job recognizing the play and getting in there for the stop.
For me, there's nothing more impressive in football than to see a cover cornerback able to come up and make the stops on the run. That's a complete football player.
Tackled around the 13-yard line. And that one's good for 5 yards through the air.
Need a good release on this pass. Keep this drive moving.
The Eagles line up with an offset eye backfield. Play action to the end zone. Not a good pass that time, Chris. He forced it right into the coverage.
Whoa, that was really lucky
lucky that one wasn't picked off. Not a good decision at all there.
From 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Akers can tie it all up right here. And he makes it. He makes that one pretty easily and puts it through for 3 points. And here's your drive summary for that last series. Here's the kick. From the 5-yard line. He's hammered at the 30. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. One man in the backfield. He drops back. Passes the line. And he dropped him in the open field. He'll pick up less than a yard on the quarterback scramble. From their own 31-yard line, the Vikings line up in an I formation. Here's the halfback. He's dropped for a loss. Tried the run, but there was nothing available.
And if you can make a running back hesitate just a little, that time you could see there really was no hole, and the running back was just fishing for a place to go.
It's third and 10. Ball on their own 30. Taylor lines up as the deep back. I formation. Drops back. Here's the pass. Brown picks it off. He's tackled around the 21-yard line. What a crucial interception.
Well, if you want to know why quarterbacks get paid so much money, there it is. They win games for you, but with mistakes like that, they can lose games for you.
Westbrook, the lone back. There's a play fake. Guns it out. Drops the sure pick. The defender got there in time to break that play up.
He did. He was able to get his hands on the ball, but if he had missed that one might have turned into a really big play.
Westbrook takes the handoff. Brought down at about the 13-yard line. That'll be a 7-yard pickup. That'll bring up third down.
Make a quick read here. Look for the guy who's open and get the ball in his hands.
Third and 3 coming up. Ball on the 14-yard line. Offset I formation in the backfield. Two minutes remaining in the fourth quarter.
All you need to do here is run some clock. Run the football up the middle.
Up the middle with a fullback. They finally get him, and it looked like he would score, but instead they'll set it up with first and goal. The Vikings take a timeout, and they've got two remaining. Pressure squarely on the defense here as they look for the goal line stand that would hold them to just a field goal. Westbrook, the ball carrier, into the end zone for a touchdown.
And how about the dunk after that play? You know, maybe we need to have an NFL slam dunk competition.
They'll look to tack on the extra point. And the point after is good. Philadelphia is up a score. Here's a quick look at the drive summary. Kicks it off. Kicks from the one. Hit and dropped at the 29-yard line. This is obviously a big possession. They have to get the ball in the end zone right here.
Well, this is it, their last opportunity. The one positive part of this for the offense, though, is that everything becomes four-down territory. So typically on offense, you get three downs. Now you get four.
He drops back. Strong throw. Mikel intercepts it. He's brought down at the 41-yard line. And they really could have done without that.
Just when you started to think this offense was starting to find themselves, they have a chance here late in the game, you throw it. Pick, that's a disaster.
They line up at the 41. Westbrook lines up as the deep back, I formation. Here's the give. He makes it to the 38-yard line. That's a 3-yard gain.
Well, that was the perfect time for them to call a blitz. They got in there, filled up all the gaps, brought down the running back for a short gain.
The Eagles come out in a single back formation. He fakes it. Throws out right. Can't hit it. And now a good opportunity to take a closer look at the play using the EA Sports.
Get this one to your halfback and let him drive it in the middle. Milk this drive for all it's worth.
He'll get it again. He's dropped at the 19. Chalk up a big gain and a first down for the ball carrier on that
big play. By a talented player. You can tell in those tough, clutch situations, he wants the ball in his hands.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. They take a knee. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 21. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Goes to one knee again.
He should probably play it safe, just down the ball.
The Vikings bring in their dime package, only three down linemen. And this has been a good one. Our final score is the Eagles 13, the Vikings 6.
Thanks, guys. This was a close one throughout. Here's a look at a few key plays as we wrap this one up. This concludes another game of Madden NFL 2009. From all of us here, thanks again for being part of this game.